your WLKY weather with Jared Heil.
All right, after the cold, cold winter we've had, it's always good to see some signs of spring. And with this warm weather, we're getting outside, and I did today in my backyard. Took some pictures up in Clark County, Indiana, of, for one, a budding maple tree. It's getting ready, of course, to put its leaves on in the coming weeks. And the first sign of green every year, of course, is the daffodils, the bulbs coming out there. And you can see those stems just poking through the ground. Vicki Dorse says that hers are a little bit taller than mine, so maybe it's just because she's a little bit farther south in Louisville than me up in Indiana. But the bottom line is, in the coming weeks, we'll have those Easter flowers coming up, and just 13 days away officially from the first day of spring. That is actually on March 20th this year. Who's counting, right? I think everybody is. Outside right now, some high clouds passing by, kind of hazy because of the light winds we have. Some air quality issues for some folks. Just keep that in mind because of the light winds we have out there right now. Temperatures in the upper 50s to right around 60, a light west breeze, and the humidity is very low at around 32%. Temperatures are very nice now across the Ohio Valley. Mid-50s in Indy, near 60 here, lower 60s farther south in yellow across the Volunteer State. And really, one more nice day of the temperatures right around 60 heading at us by your Saturday. All that sunshine warmed us very nicely today. A couple of high clouds off toward the west through Illinois and back into Missouri and Iowa. Even some light rain and snow farther west through Iowa into Nebraska and the lee side of the Rockies. That snow is piling up there, looks like, on the lee side of the Rockies just south of Denver, Colorado at this time. Storm system is on the map. That is actually a weak cold front. Most of the precip is behind the boundary in the much colder air. And look at the temperature change on that front. Low 80s across South Texas, farther north you're in the 20s and 30s. That sort of air, thankfully, is not heading in our direction, but that cold front is going to make its way toward us by your Saturday. Going forward in time, starting off in the morning, we'll see some high clouds passing by. We're dry to start the day, and that's great news. If you're heading down and running downtown at the Road City Run tomorrow morning, temperatures are going to be chilly, but we are dry. Some passing clouds, upper 30s to start. We're at 40 by 9 a.m., and by 10 o'clock, we'll finish things up. We'll be in the middle 40s by that time. And late in the day, we'll see highs in the upper 50s, right around 60. Once again, dry skies will continue, but the high clouds will increase. In the evening hours, once the front passes by, a couple of showers are possible. The good news is that's a quick hitter. We'll see some sun back at us by your Sunday. Heading out this evening, temps in the 50s, eventually in the 40s. A few passing high clouds. By 10 o'clock, 46 degrees. A few clouds will continue. In the morning, we're at 37. Again, those clouds thickening up across the area. Midday tomorrow, your temperature, not bad at all. We'll call it 51 by midday on your Saturday. Here's that 7-day forecast. Vicki and Rick, not bad tomorrow. 64 your high, couple of showers, but mainly in the evening hours and after sunset on your Saturday. By Sunday, we're at 50. Spring forward 1 hour on the clocks there before you go to bed Saturday night. Lots of sunshine Sunday, Monday, and Tuesday, and those temperatures very nice, mid and upper 60s by Monday and Tuesday before we turn colder, actually much colder, toward next Wednesday and Thursday. So enjoy the weekend and early next week.
We will.
We certainly will do that. Thank you, Jared.